Today we're going to be looking at adding four vertical X guards to this double swing gate system operated by an E124. There are four X guards and two power supplies, one power supply for the front, one power supply for the back. Inside the box you will find the manual, the X guard itself, a mounting template, very important, 10 meters of cable, the mounting base for the X guard itself, and an Allen key to adjust the X guard. Use the mounting template first of all to locate the fixing points of the X guard, making note that that shaded section is what the X guard can see, so you can't see above or to the side of it. Please make sure that you allow enough space for the X guard to be mounted and not hit anything when the gate is in the open position. This line here is your cable entry points. Ideally, mount the extra screw. Obviously, in this particular case, we won't be using it because it will hit the perspex. Repeat the same procedure for all four different mounting positions. There should be two X guards per gate. Drill your cable entry holes first. Feed your cable through. Make sure everything lines up. I'm going to be using the self-tapping screws. Once the bracket is secured, plug the cable into the lower slot. It shouldn't fit, should only fit in that one. Make sure that you fit the cover over the top. This ensures your IP rating remains and that no water can get inside. Line up that triangle piece with the line to allow you to fit it. Once in place, you can rotate it and it will lock into place. Repeat the same for the other three X guards. First thing I'm going to do is connect the power supply, and then we're going to connect the test circuit. We are only using the safety field. I've wired all the two X guards on the inside in series for the opening safety, and the two X guards in series for the closing safety. The next stage is setting them up. So you unlock the X guard first and then press one wand twice. That will enable the lasers. These lasers are now used to make sure you have aligned the X guard correctly. So you will need a little bit of fine tuning. There'll be a laser that will point straight down, and there will also be a laser that will point straight across. Now, ideally, you want to get approximately 50 mil at least away from the surface of the gate. So I'm using the Allen key to adjust that position. It angles it out. A minimum of 50 at the bottom as well. The next stage is setting the position. So you unlock again and press the square bottom two chevrons either side for the mounting position. And it's set to without reference. Please don't use width reference as will not work on this swing gate. So in this particular case, it will be number 4. If it had been the X guard on the other side, it will be number 3. The next stage is we're going to set the safety field. So first measure from the center of the X guard down to the bottom of the gate. and also the width of the gate, as we'll need those figures to put it into the safety field. So you unlock, and we're going to do the height first. So you press D, so the right starts rapid flashing, and then you enter the height, in this case 1.2. Then it goes back to the slow blinking again. You then press the button C, and it'll start doing rapid flashing again, which will be the width. You then enter the value in, and it'll go back to the slow flashing. You can also do a check, which we've done here. So you press the same button again that you want to check. So in this case, we're gonna do the D and then question mark. So you get a one green light, a dot, and then the two other green lights to tell us it's 1.2. Once we've done that, we can launch a teach-in. So you unlock to launch a teach-in. You press the wand and then you press number one. That will start a slow flashing of the lights to allow you to give enough time. At this point, we suggest to move the gate from its closed position to the open position so that the sensor can map out anything that might be in its field. What you should end up with is that the X-Guard will have two green lights on it, and the two green lights on it will remain green for the entirety of the movement of the gate itself. So just watch these two lights per X-Guard. You then repeat the same procedure for all three other X-Guards. Ideally, perform this one by one on the X-Guards, so you don't cross-program units by mistake. Once you've done that, you can then run a test cycle like we just did. This is ensuring that the gate open and closes with the X-Guards in place. This is the test object that is required to test that the X-Guards are working correctly. Please ensure that the gate does not make any contact with the test object at all, and test at various different positions. I've tested for both the open angles on both the X-Guards, and also in the center to make sure the X-Guard do see the test object and reverse before making contact. One of the things you're seeing here is this failsafe check being done, which is the lights blinking along with the X-Guard lights at the same time. The basically where the system is doing is category 2 failsafe check. Once all your work is completed, you should be good to go.